Oh, thank you so much, Vice Chancellor, for helping me with this. I really appreciate it.
No problem. Call me Nick, please.
Oh, okay. Do you mind if I ask you something? Do you mind if we listen to some music?
Yeah, sure. Absolutely.
I see a little silhouette of a man. Scaramouche, Scaramouche, will you do the fandango? Thunderbolt and lightning, very, very frightening me.
Galileo,
Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo,
Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo,
Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo,
Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo,
Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo,
Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo,
Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, Galileo,
Galileo, Galileo, Galileo, born in London, yes, but I didn't really live there for a very, mm-hmm. very long period of time.
Okay, because I mean, I love London, it's one of my favourite cities in the entire world. So, how was it your childhood in London? Did you live a period of your life in London, in your childhood?
No, I was really only there. I was born in London, mm-hmm. But then we moved away pretty quickly after that, I would say. So, I grew up in Dorset.
Mm-hmm. And how was it to be a child in Dorset in the 1960s?
This makes me sound incredibly old. Had a great time growing up by the seaside, mm-hmm. really enjoyed the scenery, and mm-hmm. I still have the love of being by the sea and on the water these days, and that's mm-hmm. sort of something that's really stayed with me, I would mm-hmm. say.
And did you have any particular favourite subject at school?
I liked, actually sport was one of my favourite subjects. I love playing sport. Academically, I think as I got a bit older, certainly at secondary school, I got very much into computer science. So mm-hmm. I remember the day quite vividly when our school had a new computer arrive, its first ever computer, which again also makes me feel incredibly old. Computing and maths, I think, were the mm-hmm. subjects I really enjoyed.
Mm-hmm. Also, I've heard that you were and still are quite keen sportsman, is that right? And you just mentioned that.
Yes, absolutely. So very keen on sport. I love playing sport all of my life. I play it a bit less these days, and I tend to watch it a bit more these days than play it. But I played soccer mm-hmm. growing up. I used to be moderately good at soccer. My mm-hmm. my career highlight, I think, was I had a trial with Aston Villa, so a Premier League football team.
That's wonderful.
As I was growing up, I wasn't good enough, so I had to be a computer scientist, mm-hmm. But I also played cricket, so those mm-hmm. were the, I would say, the two sports that I enjoyed most mm-hmm. Growing up.
Any club in particular, in terms of soccer?
So, football? For soccer, I support West Ham, which is, for most of my life, has been a somewhat miserable experience. West Ham are just one of those teams who don't seem to do very well, mm-hmm. Often fighting relegated many times, mm-hmm. And so you certainly experience the highs, some highs, mm-hmm. many more lows, okay. with West Ham.
Bubbles.
bubbles in the air. They fly so high, they reach the sky. Enjoy my dreams, they fade and die. Fortune's always hiding. Pretty bubbles in the air. They fly so high, they reach the sky. Enjoy my dreams.
Good effort.
So you then moved to the University of Exeter to study computer science, right?
Yes.
Followed by your PhD in Queen's Mary's University of London.
Yes.
So was Nick Jennings a good university student? Did you have a nice time at university?
There's a couple of ways to answer that.
Okay.
So I think I was quite a good student. I was quite a diligent student, I think. I liked computer science, mm-hmm. and so I was quite happy to work quite hard, and sort of I found university challenging, mm-hmm. in that sense. So academically it was good. I enjoyed playing sport, so I played soccer and cricket for the university in my time there. But I also made a lot of friends there, including my wife, in fact. So we met as undergraduates, and I would say my group of closest friends were those that I made at university, mm-hmm. and so there's a group of us who still see one another on a regular basis.
Aww. Just so powerful.
Look, black is beautiful, black is excellent. Black is pain, black is joy, black is evident. It's working twice as hard as the people you know you're better than, cause you need to do double what they do so you can level them. Black is so much deeper than just African American. Our heritage been severed, you never got to experiment with family trees. Could they teach you about famine and greed and show you pictures of our fam on their knees? Tell us we used to be barbaric, we had actual queens. Look. Black is growing up around a barbershop. Mummy saying stay away from trouble, you're in yard a lot. Studying for ages, appreciating the chance you got. Cause black is in your blood and you ain't even got the heart to stop. Black is stepping in for your mother because your father's gone. And standing by your children when you haven't proven karma wrong. Black is doing all of the above, then going corner shopping. Trying to help a lady cross the road to have her walking off. Black is so confusing for the culture, they're in love with it. They take our features when they want and have their fun with it. Never seem to help with all the things we know would come with it. Loud in our laughter, silent in our suffering. Black is all I know, they ain't a thing that I would change in it.
I saw it at the Brits.
Did you?
Yeah.
Live?
So, yeah, live, yes.
Wow.
I saw it live at the Brits, and it was a fantastic performance. It was just before COVID, mm-hmm. so it was the Brits before the COVID. and for a while was what kept us going,
yeah.
as the last experience that I had done, mm-hmm. before lockdown. And it was fantastically performed at the Brits. It was a new song. I hadn't heard the song and I hadn't heard the artist, but was just really blown away,
yeah,
by
great.
The performance and by the power of the lyrics, mm-hmm. I would say.
You're a member of the UK's Government AI Council, also a chair of the Royal Academy of Engineering Policy Committee. Mm-hmm. You're a fellow of several collectives such as the Royal Society, the British Computer Science, the Royal Society of the Arts, the European Artificial Intelligence Association, the list goes on and on. On top of this, you've published over 700 articles with over 90,000 citations. You're one of the world's most cited computer scientists. You were made a companion of the Order of the Bath in the Queen's New Year's Honours in 2016 for your services to computer science and national security. So, you've received several awards for your research. So, wow, that's just remarkable, and just extraordinary, the amount of things you've accomplished, the amount of accolades you've received. That's just really impressive. So do you even have time to breathe with so many things happening and going on at the same time in your life?
I would say that's spread over a reasonably long period of time, thankfully. So I haven't had to do all that in a short period of time. I've been very fortunate, I feel, in my research career. Mm-hmm. I got inspired to talk about artificial intelligence and to study it further when I was an undergraduate. So mm-hmm. It was the bit of my degree I enjoyed the most, and I just wanted to find out more about it. And sort of the particular flavour of AI that I was interested in was one where a number of AI systems would interact with one another. So they might cooperate and they might mm-hmm. coordinate, or they might negotiate and compete. And luckily, that sort of really took off as an area. So it was a fairly new area of AI at mm-hmm. the time, I would say. And at the beginning, it was a small community, and actually you would know everyone in the community because there was about 20 of you around the world.
Wow.
And so one of the really exciting things was sort of really seeing that grow from the 20 odd who knew one another to the community that it is today. But if you can really get in at the birth of an academic discipline or a sub-discipline of computer science, it enables you to have a lot of impact. And mm-hmm. I would say a lot of those things stemmed from the fact that it was a new discipline and we were really able to do new stuff that had just not been done before. Mm-hmm. You're going to play the guitar to this one? I feel it's more a guitar-y one than a singing one, but there you go.
Just nod if you can hear me. Is there anyone home? There is no pain you are seeing. The distant ships move on your horizon.
Talked about AI as your field of research. What fascinates you about this field of research? Because for me, it sounds quite complicated.
It's a technical discipline, and that's part of the interest for me. So I always found it to be the most interesting area of computer science. And there's always been general interest, I think, in society through films and books and science fiction about computers or robots being smart. And I was just really interested and intrigued into how this thing that I could program, it would do what I wanted it to do, could in any way get close to human intelligence. And that's really what excited me mm-hmm. about it. And it's been a privilege, I feel, to be a very small part of that journey and that mm-hmm. maturing of the field.
Time around. We made it with the grim and the water, fire in the sky. Smoke in the water. I can't hear anything.
I would say I spent a lot of my youth listening to it.
How did you come to Loughborough then? What happened in your life that kind of then culminated in your induction as Vice Chancellor in October 2021?
So I've been gradually having more senior leadership roles mm-hmm. in universities for a number of years, and I was a deputy at Imperial. I was a VP for, I was the VP for research and enterprise, and so I was felt ready to take on the ultimate leadership role of a university, which is the vice chancellor mm-hmm. role. And I wanted to come to a place where I genuinely felt I could make a real difference mm-hmm. to it. And Loughborough for me was that place. Loughborough has been fantastic over the last decade or so in terms of its education and mm-hmm. student experience, which you'll know very well because you've experienced it. We've been a bit less strong institutionally, I think, on research and innovation. We've had lots of good research, but we've not perhaps had the institutional focus on it. And mm-hmm. that's a bit my background. I also wanted to do something around student entrepreneurship mm-hmm. and international engagement to really sort of spread the word about Loughborough. And so I felt that what Loughborough needed was the kinds of things that I was interested in and felt I had a good understanding of. And then also, for me, the whole sport piece here at Loughborough was something real mm-hmm. icing on top of the cake. I wanted to lead a great university, and leading a great university that has real strength in sport is a real added mm-hmm. bonus.
Well, now you're leading one of the best in the world.
Absolutely, yes.
Look at the stars, look how they shine for you, and everything you do. Yeah, they were all yellow. I came along, I wrote a song for you, and all the things you do. So then I took my turn. Oh, what a thing to have done. And it was all yellow.
This was the first big mega band concert that we went to as a family. So both my kids and my wife liked Coldplay, and we persuaded the kids to come with their parents to a concert, which was at that stage not too embarrassing, I would say. And they were fantastic, Coldplay, mm-hmm. and that was just a really great song when they sang it live. Mm-hmm.
So is this role of being a Vice Chancellor your ultimate chance to give university students the university experience with things they perhaps didn't have when you were a university student?
I hope so. So it's a chance as Vice Chancellor to shape the university. And as I say, we do, I feel, here at Loughborough, a pretty good job of with our education and student experience. Mm-hmm. I think you have a...
Yeah, I can confirm that.
You have a great student experience here. What I can bring to it is some other elements in terms of the research and the entrepreneurship and activities like that I think we're we can get stronger at that will make us an even better university.
Are those the goals for the next couple of years?
Yeah, so last year we launched a new strategy, Creating Better Futures Together, and those are the key elements of that. That's what I want us to achieve as a university. And one of the things I was very pleased about was really getting buy-in from the staff and the students and the alumni in the strategy. We had over a thousand people involved in that conversation to come up with something. So it's not my strategy, it's the university's strategy.
Tell me something, girl. Are you happy in this modern world? Or do you need more? Is there something else you're searching for? I'm falling. In all the good times, I find myself longing for change. Then in the bad times, I fear myself. I'm off the deep end, watch as I dive in. I never meet the ground. Crash to the surface where they can't hurt us. We're far from the shallow now. In the shallow. In the shallow. In the shallow. We're far from the shallow now. Oh, here we are. Oh, thank you so much, Vice Chancellor. I really appreciate it.
Thank you. Enjoy your lecture.
Thank you.
It's the top button.
Oh! Thank you.
Bye. Cheers, Rafael.